Damn, son, where'd you find this?
You've been learning math for a while, then you probably already know a thing or two about fractions. And if you've ever had to, well, break a cookie in half to share with a friend, well, then you've used fractions in real life. Oh, well, thank you. That's because fractions are used to represent smaller pieces or parts of things.
Write down the fraction thing, grab your pen and get ready for some action. Fraction. Lil Annex gonna teach you how to add. First grab graph paper or a notepad. Next step is to check for common denominators on your paper. If there's none, then get one for the outcome. LCM is a number like 13. This isn't too bad, next just add. Then simplify, fast step is last. A plus, you just passed. My expectations are surpassed. You just passed, math class. I'm happy beyond belief, I can barely believe. Next I gotta subtract.
Grab next to Lukei Pooki.
With the steps to that.
Fractions.
So, lemme tell you about some subtraction, fractions. I got a lot of passion for fractions. I'll take you through the actions of subtraction. Get rid of the distractions. So, first, let's get to the worst. Multiply the denominator by the other. What you do to one side, you do to the other. Gotta multiply in both numerators to the diagonal denominators. Once you get that, get ready to subtract. Subtract, top for top, and bottom for bottom. This will deliver us to the difference. So that was subtraction, fractions.
Can you repeat that, please, man?
Multiply the denominator by the other. What you do to one side, you do to the other. Gotta multiply in both numerators to the diagonal denominators. Once you get that, get ready to subtract. Subtract, top for top, and bottom for bottom. This will deliver us to the difference. So that was subtraction, fractions.
When you're first learning about fractions, it can help to draw pictures to see how they work. So let's start by drawing a circle. Now this circle represents what we call a hole. Now, not the kind of hole you can fall into. More like a whole cookie or a whole pizza.
Hey yo, Lil Zapp.
Now if we divide that circle or hole amount.
I'm going to show you some multiplying fractions. Lil Zapp's about to teach you some methods. Let me show you the paper. I'm going to teach you about multiplying fractions. Do it faster than my transaction. Here we have the numerator. It's the number on top of the line. The denominator is the number below. All right, let me teach you a formula. Multiply the two numerators first. What do we do with the denominators? We do the same thing as we do with the numerators. Multiply. I also have a way to do mixed numbers. We multiply the denominator with the whole number. We add the numerator, and then we have an improper fraction. Finally, we simplify.
Fractions. 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 Fractions.
Whoa! It's a vision with fractions. It's a mission, man. Don't be slacking. Open up your minds to learn, even though it might hurt. I'll show you the method, even though it might sound absurd. Yeah, I'll explain it in a couple of words. You gotta keep it changing, flip it, then you multiply. Might sound like a lot, but don't you cry. Don't be shy. Come on, man. Just give it a try. Here's an example. It's gonna give you some substantial amount of help. We're gonna get there, man. Don't you yell. 2/3 divided by 4. Follow the steps. It'll take off the curse. You gotta keep the first part, then you gotta change it. The divide is now a multiply sign. Now this is the part where you gotta rearrange it. I got a tidbit though. Use the reciprocal. 1/4 now becomes 4/1. Ain't that fun? No. Well, y'all gotta go. Now you just multiply. 2 × 4 = 8. Man, that's great. 3 × 1 = 3. Y'all better listen close to me. 8 is over 3. What? That makes no sense. Take a deep breath, man. Don't get tense. 'Cause 3 can go into 8 twice. Man, that's nice. 8 - 6 = 2. Now you put that over 3, and that's the answer for you. You see, the answer is 2 2/3. I'll be not bored, 'cause we got a little more to go, and I got a little more to show. Yeah, it's a mixed number. I bet you don't care or wonder. That's okay, 'cause I'm explaining anyway. It's a mix between a whole number and a fraction. I bet you don't think how that happened. Well, you don't have 8/3. That's improper, like a trap underwater. Yeah, fractions aren't art. Now this concludes my rapping part. Woo!
To really understand how fractions are used to represent parts of things, be sure to do the exercises. And I'll see you in section 2.